We are less than a month from the midterm elections, and so as a public service to you, we're continuing our focus on the swampiness of candidates on the ballot in November. This time, it's two Democrats in vital Senate races. Tennessee's Phil Bredesen and Indiana's Joe Donnelly are tonight's Swamp Watch. The Kavanaugh confirmation battle seems to have fired up many Americans on both sides of the fight, and one of them was no less than music superstar Taylor Swift, who plunged into the fray last week with her first ever political endorsement. She couldn't possibly vote for conservative Trump supporter Marsha Blackburn in her home state's key Senate race, Taylor Swift announced. Vote for Democrat Phil Bredesen, she told her 112 million Instagram followers. Bredesen, didn't anyone tell Taylor Swift about his record on sexual harassment? This endorsement might just end up with teardrops on her guitar. In 2005, while serving as governor of Tennessee, Bredesen employed a lobbyist as his senior advisor for legislation and policy. That's already pretty swampy. But worse, this lobbyist was suspended for workplace harassment. When local reporters began investigating the incidents that led to the suspension, they were shocked to find that state investigators had literally shredded all the notes that had been taken during an internal investigation. The top investigator reportedly admitted to being, quote, keenly aware that documentation would have been later requested as public records. Bredesen denied covering up harassment in his office, arguing it was all part of an effort to protect the identities of victims. Because Democrats really care about that, of course. Just ask Dianne Feinstein. Then Governor Bredesen told reporters at the time, there's nothing to be covered up here, but admitted, I don't have any way of proving that to you. You can say that again. And in fact, he kind of had to, because the same thing happened again. Just 2 months later, Bredesen's Department of Corrections Commissioner, Quentin White, resigned amid sexual harassment accusations. Governor Bredesen confirmed a sexual assault allegation from 2004, but said investigators found no corroboration of the claim. Guess what happened to those investigation notes? They were shredded too. Can you imagine what Democrats would have said if this had happened with Brett Kavanaugh? Oh, we did an investigation into Christine Blasey Ford's allegations, but we can't tell you about it because someone shredded the notes. I think Democrats would be shredding whoever said that. And surely they'd be shredding whoever said this. At the time of the Tennessee state government sexual harassment scandals, a senior official acknowledged the problem, but then said, quote, any time you mix men and women together in a work environment, there's going to be issues. Great. And guess who said that? None other than Taylor Swift's new political heartthrob, Democratic Senate candidate Phil Bredesen. I've got no problem with Taylor Swift getting political, but if she's going to pose as a champion for women and a supporter of the Me Too movement, it might be an idea for her not to endorse men whose motto for official sexual harassment claims amounts to shake it off.